Respiratory sounds. Ever since Sir Lennox discovered the stethoscope in 1816, to the today's world where high-tech equipment surround the doctor, the classical impression of a physician in the minds of the common man has been with a stethoscope in his ears with the chest piece resting over the chest. And undoubtedly, auscultation gives us more information about the respiratory system than any other method of physical examination. This cassette will help you to understand the various respiratory sounds in health and in disease. For best results, you must use a good quality tape recorder. Small portable players will not produce actual sounds. Keep the volume to the minimum required for listening. High volumes distort the pitch. And for a more natural feel, listen to the breath sounds through your stethoscope with the chest piece held 6 inches away from the speaker of the tape recorder. During the auscultation for breath sounds, remember that breath sounds are of very low intensity as compared to the heart sounds. So the auscultation must be done in a quiet room, you must listen with greater concentration, and you and the patient must be in a comfortable position. The patient should preferably be in a sitting or standing position. Use the diaphragm of the stethoscope for auscultating breath sounds. First, auscultate the anterior chest with the arms by the side of the body, then the axillary areas with the arms abducted, and then the back with the patient leaning slightly forwards with head flexed and arms crossed to pull the scapulae apart. You should listen to at least one full breath in each location. If the patient is bedridden, then auscultate the anterior chest and axillae in the supine position. Then turn the patient to one side and auscultate the upper side of the back, then turn him to the other side and auscultate the second side. During auscultation, ask the patient to open the mouth and take deep breaths through the mouth without making any extra sound. Nasal breathing may produce wheezing sounds, especially on deep inspiration if there is nasal obstruction, so the breathing should be through open mouth. And the intensity of the breath sounds during quiet breathing is too low for auscultation. Hence, the patient is asked to take deep or forced breaths. Now, before we actually auscultate the breath sounds, let us first learn how they are produced and what are their components. The breath sounds are produced by turbulent airflow in the upper airways. This original sound is a hissing sound containing frequencies ranging from 200 to 2000 Hz. As the sound is transmitted through the lung tissue and the chest wall, the higher frequencies are lost and a softer, lower pitched sound with frequencies ranging from 200 to 400 Hz is heard. This is the normal breath sound heard at the base of the lung and is termed as vesicular breath sound. Listen to the vesicular breath sound and note its soft, low pitched, rustling quality. It was believed that this sound was produced in the smaller bronchioles and the alveoli, and hence it was named as vesicular sound. But actually, the small bronchioles and the vesicles act as filters which absorb the higher frequencies. In some diseased conditions, as in consolidated lung, the tracheobronchial sound is transmitted completely without loss of the higher frequencies, and then the breath sound is louder, higher pitched and blowing. Listen to this loud, high-pitched and blowing sound termed as the bronchial breath sound or the tracheal breath sound. Now let us auscultate a normal chest. Over most of the lung, away from the center, you can hear the slow, low-pitched, rustling vesicular breathing. Over the larynx, trachea, upper sternum, and posteriorly over the lower cervical spine, you can hear the loud, higher pitched and blowing tracheal or bronchial breathing. and close to the upper part of the sternum in the infraclavicular areas, and on the back around 3rd and 4th thoracic vertebrae, you hear a mixed or bronchovesicular breathing. Now let us study the characteristics of these sounds and the ways to identify them. The breath sound in each respiration has two components, inspiration and expiration. In the vesicular breath sounds heard over normal lung tissue, the inspiration is louder and higher pitched than expiration. Inspiration is 3 to 5 times longer than the expiration because audible component of the expiration is very short. There is no pause between inspiration and expiration. And it has an overall rustling or breezy quality, like the wind blowing through a tree producing rustle of the leaves. In bronchial breath sounds, the expiration is louder and higher pitched than inspiration. Expiration is as long as or longer than the inspiration. There is a pause between inspiration and expiration due to the absence of the vesicular component. And the sounds have an overall loud, high-pitched and blowing quality. The bronchovesicular breath sounds have characteristics intermediate between the vesicular and the bronchial breath sounds. So their characteristics vary depending on which component is more prominent. Here the expiration is louder, longer and higher in pitch. But there is no pause between inspiration and expiration. This type of sound is produced when normal air-containing lung tissue is interposed between a large bronchus and the chest wall, thus combining the characteristics of both vesicular and bronchial breathing. So now, after understanding the three types of breath sounds heard over different parts of the chest in health, let us proceed to the abnormal breath sounds. First, let us study the abnormal vesicular breath sounds. Listen to the normal vesicular breath sounds, which have a rustling quality. Inspiration is louder, longer and higher pitched than expiration, and there is no pause between inspiration and expiration. These vesicular sounds may be exaggerated or loud in children, if the chest wall is thin, after exertion, and during excitement and overbreathing. Pathologically, they may be louder and harsher in states of dyspnea, bronchitis, compensatory emphysema, and tuberculous infiltration. When harsh, they may be termed as harsh vesicular breath sounds. Now listen to normal breath sounds. And harsh vesicular breath sounds. The vesicular breath sounds may be reduced or faint during quiet, shallow breathing and in obese or thick chest walls. Pathologically, diminished breath sounds are heard either because of shallow respiration in painful chest conditions, weakness of respiratory muscles, massiveositis or emphysema, or due to defective conduction in pleural effusion, pneumothorax, thickened pleura or peripheral malignant growths. The breath sounds may be totally absent in large pleural effusion, pneumothorax and lung collapse due to complete occlusion of a bronchus. Another abnormality commonly seen with vesicular breath sounds is prolonged expiration, typically seen in chronic bronchitis, asthma and emphysema due to the narrowing of the bronchioles and sometimes in early tuberculous infiltration due to the loss of elasticity of the lung tissue. Note that though expiration is prolonged and longer than inspiration, its rustling character is maintained. In asthma, the expiratory sound is typically harsh, prolonged, and wheezy in character, while inspiration is normal and may be associated with ronchi and rales. Now let us turn our attention to the various types of bronchial breathing. Listen to the bronchial breath sounds, which have a blowing quality, a harsh, high-pitched and prolonged expiratory sound, and a pause between inspiration and expiration. When lung tissue is consolidated or solidified, the laryngotracheal sound is transmitted to the chest wall without any alteration, that is without filtration of the higher frequencies, and bronchial breath sounds are heard over areas where normally vesicular sounds are heard. These sounds are of different intensity and pitch depending on the site, extent and nature of the lesion and the size of the underlying air passage, that is the bronchus. For example, a lung cavity behaves like a large bronchus and produces low-pitched or cavernous breath sounds. While in lobar pneumonia, the small patent bronchi produce higher-pitched or tubular breath sounds. Now let us study these sounds in details. Cavernous breath sounds. Cavernous breath sounds are low-pitched bronchial breath sounds heard if there is an underlying lung cavity with irregular walls or in open pneumothorax. Sometimes a trachea pulled to one side may also produce cavernous sounds over it. Note the low-pitched hollow character. Also note the characteristics of bronchial breath sounds, that is, expiration is louder and higher pitched than inspiration. Expiration is as long as or longer than inspiration. And there is a pause between inspiration and expiration. Tubular breath sounds. Tubular breath sounds are high-pitched bronchial breath sounds heard classically in lobar pneumonia. They are also heard in tuberculous pneumonia, lung collapse with partial obstruction of the bronchus and malignancy, where the lung is solidified and some of the bronchi are patent. Listen to the high-pitched tubular bronchial breath sounds. also note the characteristics of bronchial breath sounds. That is, expiration is louder and higher pitched than inspiration. Expiration is as long as or longer than inspiration. And there is a pause between inspiration and expiration. Sometimes tubular breath sounds are heard in massive pleural effusion and empyema, probably because of better transmission of the bronchial sounds through the collapsed lung to the fluid collection. Amphoric breath sounds. This is a high-pitched bronchial breathing with an echo-like or metallic quality. It indicates a large, smooth-walled, open cavity in the lung or a pneumothorax communicating with a bronchus. Here, the large space in the cavity or pneumothorax amplifies the high-pitched vibrations, giving it an echo-like quality. Listen to the amphoric breath sounds and note the echo-like quality. Also note the characteristics of bronchial breath sounds, that is, pause between inspiration and expiration, and high-pitched prolonged expiration. At this stage, let us revise the various breath sounds that we have heard. Vesicular breath sounds. Harsh vesicular breath sounds. Bronchovesicular breath sounds. Vesicular breath sounds with prolonged expiration. Bronchial breath sounds. Cavernous bronchial breath sounds. Tubular bronchial breath sounds. Amphoric bronchial breath sounds.